Looking for easy-to-use video editing software? Filmora just got your back. Welcome to the basics of Filmora Video Editor. This is the first interface if you are going to open the application. You are to choose which ratio of your screen that you wanted to work with. Mostly, if you are going to upload a video on YouTube, then that should be 16:9 ratio or a widescreen mode. The rest of the screens here are rarely being used. To create your first project, you can click here in the new project. If you want to open existing project, you can go here in open project. Filmora also puts an option here below. You can uncheck this if you don't want to see this window. This project library only displays your current projects by current date created. Now, let's move on. This is now the overview of the main editing interface of Filmora. This section is called your media library, where you'll learn how to import media or source files, how to rearrange them, and how to create a very simple video with an audio later on. Filmora has already provided sample videos and colors here, and we will going to use them for our first creation of video. In this section, you can also find sample audio files here categorized by genre. We have also here built-in titles for your editing, and as you can see, they are categorized according to their types. You can browse all over here and there are lots of styles. You can also see different types of transitions here, including basic transitions, 3D, ripple and dissolve, and there's a lot more. Same with different effects here, we have filters and overlays. Both are interrelated, but their only difference is that filters are external effects while overlays are internal. We have also here utility, or sometimes they call it as power tool, which is used for advanced editing. We have also LUT effects here. By the way, LUT stands for lookup table. LUTs are generally used and applied in movies, if you're up into watching movies. As you can see, LUTs are applied according to what type of movie in order to place a significance to the whole concept. If you want to add moving objects or motion graphics, or sometimes closer to GIFs, you can go to Elements section. These elements can enhance your video. There are lots of different elements that can be found here. We have also split screen here, or sometimes they call multi-screen. These are used for adding two or more videos in a single screen to display different shots or to compare between two or more clips. To import videos and other files, you can pull down this import menu and choose your preferred task. Or if you want the easier way, you can click anywhere in this area to import your files. And one of the best feature of Filmora is that, it has built-in record section. You can either record here from a webcam, PC screen, or you can use VoiceOver. This area is your preview window. This shows the preview of your video while you are editing. All of here inside your libraries can be previewed by double-clicking the file. These buttons are called backward and forward frames, in which you can move a frame left and right. This icon is for preview quality and display settings. You can choose playback quality of video, and by default, it sets as 1/2 only. This icon is used to take a snapshot of a video that automatically saves and appears in the media library. This icon is volume for your video and audio files. And this icon is to preview the full screen of your video. This icon is render preview. It is used to render video for smoother playback. Always practice rendering your video to avoid any interruptions and lags while playing your video. Other stuffs here are easy to understand, and are barely being used. So this area is your quick toolbars. You have here the undo and redo button, delete button, and the cut or split button, but as you go along with your editing, you will no longer use these toolbar icons here. Because all shortcuts are already here, in this section, which is called your timeline. Timeline is where you do most of your dragging and editing tasks. All of your media files and different kinds of effects will be gathered in this area. So now that you're already familiar with the editing interface. In our next video tutorial, we will be creating our first simple editing, which will include editing your video, audio, pictures, and adding text and titles to your project. So, thanks for watching this video and have a great day.